tell you, life isn't just what you think. It's full of puzzles, still just a puzzle to me. And every time you think you're ahead, it's not what it seems. Life tends to happen while you're still making your plans. So dare to dream big, 'cause it's worth taking a chance. And when tomorrow comes, you will know you gave everything. So just do what you love and love what you do. There's so many things in life and they're all here for
just
you.
Do what you love and do it for you.
Smile every day. You can do anything. At times we find ourselves by the risk that we take. Turns out the best part, life is the love that we make. Seek the answers to all your questions. What can you see? We're all connected in life, we're all part of the same. The time we have here, short, but it's worth everything. No matter what, just know that there's nothing you cannot be. So just do what you love and love what you do. There's so many things in life and they're all here for
just
you.
Do what you love
and do it for you. Smile every day. You can do
and
it.
At times
it'll feel just like when it rains it pours, you will see. And at times it'll sing just like all the walls closed in on me. Just gotta you love and love what you do. There's so many things in life and they're all here for
just
you.
Do what you love
and do it for you. Smile every day. You can do anything.
as long as I can breathe. I told you I shouldn't have had that muffin this morning.
Smiling at her. Don't look so serious. You'll come out a little nicer than you
talk. Lisa, they may need your help.
Oh, I got it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Ask for prophecies, they will pass away. Ask for tongues, they will cease. Ask for knowledge, it will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in the mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, and I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love.
The day after marriage blossom. And you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter for each other. And you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth for the other. And there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. And you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you. Treat yourselves and each other with respect, and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to tenderness and gentleness and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between you, not only the part which seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when the clouds hide the face of the sun in your lives, remembering that even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is still there. And if each takes of you responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and delight. May beauty surround both of you on the journey ahead and through all the years. May happiness be your companion always. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your life together. And may your days be good and long upon the earth.
Well, I suppose if we were to pick a word for the hour, it might be love. Mm-hmm. What do you think? Shall we go for that? It's my understanding that in the Greek language, there's three different words for love. Maybe there's others in the Greek language, but at least three. First off, eros, from which we get the thought that we are endowed with a special capacity to observe beauty when it is present. Beautiful lady.
Hmm? Absolutely.
Yeah, there you go. Handsome fellow. There we are. Thanks be to God that we have this gift. Then the next word is philios. Philios is friendship. Loving relationships between brothers and sisters, parents and their children. If I have any spare time on my hands, I want to spend it with you. Sort of love. City of Philadelphia gets its name from this word. City of brotherly and sisterly affection. That's the translation of that word. How many of you have been to Philadelphia? Can I see your hands? Well, there's quite a few of you. Didn't you not notice how much more friendly and outgoing folks from Philadelphia are? not so? Well, it is still a good idea. That, a wonderful idea that we might find ourselves living in a place where people are really neighborly and outgoing and fun to be around. That's, I would assume, Philadelphia, but I guess not altogether, but it's still a great idea. When Paul is writing the letter that you read a portion of, he's not using eros or philios for love. He's using a third word. This one's called agape. It's not Apache, it's agape. Did you catch that? I mean, it's kind of interesting. I've never said that before. But I don't know that I've had Apache reading alongside the agape letter, but that's kind of an obvious thing. Agape is, unlike the other two, not based on emotion. First two, emotion, that's the source of them. This one is based on the will. This one says, in effect, I will love you. I choose to love you. I am determined to love you. Even though, right at the moment, it's a bit of a struggle. And I think we all know about that because while we have the best of intentions, in terms of care for and loving intentions towards the people that are closest to us, we don't always pull that off. Sometimes we fall short of that. So in the scriptures, the imagery that's chosen to give the idea that we fall short, it's that of an archer pulling back on a bow and sending an arrow towards a target, the intended target, but not really pulling back as much as it needs for that arrow to fly to the target, much less the center of the target. We fall short. And we all have done that, unless there's somebody here that might like to claim that kind of perfection that's unusual. I don't see any hands going up. So it's the way it is. It's sort of reality. Some things, yeah, we hit it right on the target. We do it really well. And other things, we fall short, even in our intentions, as well as actually pulling off the whatever it's going to be. And agape, in effect, is a kind of love that says, look, I'm a realist. I know you want to do it. I know that you've tried to do it. We've talked about it, but you know, and every now and then we're going to fall short of the target. But I love you, and that's not enough to spoil the intentions I have to make life together. And so I'm in a forgiving mood of necessity. Because you're going to forgive me of certain things, and I'm going to be forgiving you, and we're going to hang together. This is going to be really a good thing. And the power to do that comes as a gift of the Spirit, because in the nature of things, when you're talking about interpreting the scriptures, when Paul and John and others are writing about love as God is love, they use agape. It is the willful nature of God to love us before we're perfect. And you know, parents do the same thing. They love their children before they're perfect. Isn't that amazing? I mean, there we are. It's humanized for us. It's just the way the goodness of life gets delivered to the people we care about. So agape is a good word for love. Because it's an empowering word. It's a word that says, I'm there for you, in spite of the fact that from time to time, you know, it really does bother me. But you can count on me, because I'm going to be there. And the wording here is marvelous, because it sounds extravagant and extraordinary, but it's the most real love of all, I think. Eros is good, and Philios is wonderful, but this is really essential. And listen how it unfolds. This love is patient. It's kind, not envious or boastful, arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Now, this is the passage you chose. This is the scripture you chose. Great passage, wonderful, very practical, and very wonderful. So, now I can't do the same thing with agape. Maybe, can you help the folks with that at some point? Okay, well, this is a wonderful day for all of us that are here. Thanks be to God for this. Now, I have a question. Who presents Leslie to Mary Terry? And who presents Terry to Mary Leslie?
Thank you.
Thank you. And I have just one little more comment to make about this. That my sense is they're doing pretty well, pretty nicely. Things are going fine for them. And I suspect that every single person here to some degree has had an influence in their lives to help them along the way to become the people that they're becoming. And today you know what you've done to help them become who they are. Take all the credit you want today. That's, you know, you just take all the credit you want. But we're going to give special recognition to some folks that have had the most of all right now.
Love you, darling.
Things that happens when I meet with couples for a service like this in this church, you provide, as a matter of kind of like homework, a list of things that you find are important to each other as value statements, things that matter to you in your relationship. And you gave me a very nice list, and I told you that I would be taking those assertions and converting those into a set of questions, which I'm about to ask you now, the answer to which is I do. And if we get the three I do's, we'll continue with the service. And here they are, Leslie and Terry. Do you imagine that you will continue in your willingness to explore and discover each other's interests, common love that you have for adventure and travel? Do you?
I do.
Okay. Do you intend to keep a common focus on children and family, talking, sharing, and enjoying your communication? Do you?
I do.
Okay. And do you believe you will continue loving each other's company and spending time with friends and family?
I do.
Good. Okay, all three. Sounds good to me. Now a more traditional declaration of intent. Terry, will you have Leslie to be your wife, and will you pledge your faithfulness to her in all love and honor, duty and service, faith and tenderness, to live with her and to cherish her according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? Will you?
I will.
Okay. Did everybody hear him?
I will.
Okay. That's better. I think that's better. Okay.
Thank you.
Leslie, will you have Terry to be your husband, and will you pledge your faithfulness to him in all love and honor, duty and service, faith and tenderness, to live with him and to cherish him according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? Will you?
I will.
Okay, that came through. Nice. Now, facing you, facing each other here, taking your hands however you wish,